In this Botpress tutorial for beginners, you'll learn how to build a custom trained AI chatbot with a ChatGPT-like conversation experience. Botpress is free to use and deploy with very generous caps of free usage. For over 6 years, Botpress has been a leading choice in AI chatbot creation. Botpress is intuitively designed, making chatbot creation simple and effortless, even those with limited technical skill. So who is Botpress for? To name a few, educators, designers, developers, chatbot enthusiasts, and businesses seeking to enhance user engagement. Before we jump in and learn how to build an AI chatbot, if you find value out of this Botpress chatbot tutorial for beginners, I'd really appreciate it if you were to reward me by using my link to Botpress in the description and pinned comment below, as well as liking this video, of course. Now let's get into it. So after clicking the link I mentioned, you'll get sent to the Botpress website. And here we are on the homepage. You can see a little bit of information. You can build ChatGPT chatbots surprisingly fast, and that's no joke. We're being powered by OpenAI, and down the bottom of the page here, you can see how quick and easy and intuitive it is to build your chatbot. And the best thing is, it's absolutely free to use, no credit card required. So to get started, we're gonna log in by creating a new account. And again, we can see on the left here that when you build your chatbot, you get 1,000 free messages every month, which means this is free for most users, as most people won't go over this cap. If you do go over the cap, the prices are definitely more than reasonable. In fact, the current pricing structure is only $10 per additional 1,000 messages, so you do need to be a rather large company to be hitting these marks. You can see a few other details about what you get with Botpress, and what is great is you get the ChatGPT-like conversation experience. And you can bring in all of your information from your database, everything about your company via a URL in just minutes. And you can see some of the brands that trust this product. So we'll go ahead and sign up with an email and password. Great, we're now inside the Botpress dashboard. In this demonstration, we're going to show you how to set up an AI chatbot assistant for a scuba diving company in Gili Islands called Manta Dive. We're going to have the assistant answer some basic questions that a potential customer might have when they come to the website, such as, have they been diving before? What kind of activities do they want to do? What are their qualifications? And then we'll have a section where the customer wants to ask some in-depth questions where we use the AI database of the knowledge of the website to answer the questions for us. Let's get started with this Botpress chatbot tutorial and learn how to make a chatbot. So the first step is to go ahead and create the chatbot, then go ahead and edit it. We're then presented with four different options to create our AI chatbot. One that answers questions on documents, questions from websites. We can start from a template, or we can even access the tutorial within the I need handholding section. And this is very useful to start off with. But for today, we're going to start from a template. We have a few to choose from, but we'll go ahead and select the basic template. Here we are inside the Botpress chatbot builder area. And once again, we're going to use information from the Manta Dive Resort to create our chatbot assistant. And what we'd like to have eventually is a little chatbot button in the bottom right here, like you see on many different websites. Now, at first, everything might seem a little bit confronting, but we have got a couple of resources down here where we can get some quick references to different things. We've got documentation for people doing different things, but what we want to do is learn how to publish your own chatbot. Here is the getting started guide, and I'll just flick through this real quick so you can see what kind of information is included here. Botpress has put in a lot of effort into making it easy for you to navigate the building process and not have to always resort to looking at YouTube videos and things like that. Okay, back to the Botpress chatbot builder area, and we can see we've got two nodes here, start and end. There's three main components to building a chatbot. We have what's called nodes, we have cards, and we have expressions. The nodes are basically steps along the way for what a customer will have to go through. And inside each of these nodes, we have what's called cards, which is action items within that. And then we also have expressions, which help direct which path we're going on through the chatbot journey. The first thing we'll do is create a node, and we'll call it hello. This is the first response that the user will get when they type in something into the chatbot. Now we need to add a card to this. Now looking at the cards, we have different types: send messages, execute commands, follow logic, AI tasks, and capture information. We'll start with just a text card, which is going to be like an introduction. Okay, hello and welcome to Manta Dive Gili Trawangan. Nice and simple. Now we're going to capture some information from the customer. We're actually going to use a multiple choice question. The type of value we want to extract is multiple choice. We're going to ask, what kind of scuba diving are you interested in? And we're going to store this information in a packet called answer. Now we're going to click here and come down and select choice. So we're going to give it three choices. The first is, I've never been, I just want to try it out. We'll select another item. I want to do a course to get certified. We'll select another item. I'm already qualified. I want to do a fun dive. So there's our first node. We've given it a few different answers there. And now we need to connect the start node to the hello node by just drawing a line like this. From here, because we've got three questions, we want to have three answers. We want to choose a new node for each of these answers. We'll call this one try, this one course, and the last one qualified. Next, we'll link up each of these nodes to the corresponding question and answer from the first node. Next, we'll add some text here with some friendly information like excellent, you're going to love it. We have a great introduction experience for you called discover scuba diving. Again, with the second option, we'll choose a text card. Excellent course are a fun way to get immersed. We have some great options for you. Lastly, for qualified, I'll again use a text card. Excellent, welcome back to the underwater world. Now, I need to find out something from my customer here, and I'm going to add a sub question for this node. I'm going to capture some information first, which will allow me to start using some expressions. And I'm going to ask a question. It's important to know how many months has it been since your last dive? And if it's been more than 6 months, we need to get the customer to do a refresher course. So with this information capture, I'm going to select for it to search for a number, and I'm going to give it two options, greater than a number or less than a number. So if the duration is 6 or more, that is 6 or more months, that will lead us down one path. However, if the duration is less than 6, that'll put us down a different path. You can see when we input these labels, there's a little bit of AI magic happening in the background, which creates a bit of code in the background, which we don't need to see. So how many nodes do you think we need to create to address these two expressions? You'd be right if you thought 2. So for the first one, we're gonna say, this person needs a refresher course. And for the second node, it'll be, this person is ready to do a fun dive. And we'll link these two nodes back with the first question. We'll add text cards to both of these new nodes. One saying, great, you'll need to do a refresher dive because it's been longer than 6 months. And the other, great, looks like you're ready to do some fun dives with us straight away. Okay, the first part of this Botpress chatbot is starting to take shape. So let's test it out a little bit. We'll come down the bottom here and type in hi. We get the introduction message. What kind of scuba diving are you interested in? I'm already qualified, I want to do a fun dive. Great, welcome back to the underwater world. How many months has it been since your last dive? And I can put in 8 months. Well, as it's been longer than 6 months, you'll need to do a refresher course. So now that we've introduced the customer to the web page, we've given it some options on what they'd like to do. We've given them recommendations based on if they've dived before or not and how long it's been. Now we're going to go ahead and ask them if they have any further questions. And this is where we're going to incorporate the AI knowledge database into the power of this chatbot. So we'll go ahead and create a new node once again and call it question. We'll bring in this card called single choice and ask them if they have any more questions. We'll choose the choice variable and give it two options, yes and no. Now that we've got that question, we need to link up these nodes from the different experiences into the question. Next, we also need to add in an expression to direct it to go from one node to the other. And for this expression, we're going to say always, so it's always true. So that in every case that we get to the try or the course or the refresher or fun paths of the chatbot, it will go directly into the questions. Now that we've got all our paths set, we're ready for the next step. So first of all, if the customer has no more questions, we'll send it to the end of the chat. However, if they do have a question, here is where we're going to set up the Botpress chatbot AI knowledge base. We'll create a new node here and call it AI knowledge. And now we're going to go ahead and add the single choice card, link the yes response from the question node into the AI knowledge node. Next, we want to get it to extract the value raw input. So this could be anything like text-based or number-based. And we'll ask it, what would you like to know? Now we'll go ahead and add the knowledge base. We'll click up here, add knowledge base. We'll give it a title, Manta knowledge base. And we'll click this button and we can either upload documents, specific web pages, or a web search from a root domain, or even a text document. In this case, we'll go for web search, and we'll copy and paste in the root of this website, which is manta/dive.com. Now we have all the information available from this website built into this knowledge base. Coming back to the AI knowledge node, we'll click this, and we need to now enable knowledge answering. So just like that, we've enabled this node to have access to the AI knowledge, and we can see that from this book icon here. Next thing we need to do is give it a couple of expressions. We'll first need to give it an expression where it doesn't know the answer to the question. So we'll use this special command, !turn.knowledgeagent.responded. And for when there is no answer to the question that we've asked, we need to send it to another node, which is like an error node, which we'll call sorry. We'll add in the text of sorry, I don't have that information. Next, we'll need to add another expression of always, because we want to create a little bit of a loop here. We connect the AI knowledge base, don't know the answer, to the sorry node. And then after that apology has been given, we want to bring it back to the question. Do you have any more questions? Same with when there is an answer given by the AI knowledge base, we still want it to come back and ask if you have any more questions. From there, if there's no more questions, it will go to the end of the chat. So in summary, we can see that we've got the start here. The customer comes in, they're welcomed. We've asked them what kind of experience they want. And with this one, we've got some sub options of how long has it been since they've dived. But in each of these cases, we get them sent over to, do they have any more questions? If they don't, that ends. Or if they do, we access the AI knowledge base to find out what they want to know. If there's no answer, we come back to the start of the loop. And if there is an answer, again, we come back to the start of the loop until the customer has no more questions. Let's test it out. So we'll start with hi. We get welcomed and we have our initial question. We've already done this one, so let's go with I've never been, I just want to try it out. Okay, great, we've got an experience there for us. Do I have any more questions? No. And then we see we come to the conversation being ended. Let's try another one. This time we'll choose I want to do a course to get certified. Great, here's a couple of options we have. Do you have any more questions? Yes. What do we'd like to know? Let's find out a little bit more about the open water course. So now we're telling it to go to the website and access information based around what the open water course is all about. And you can see here we have the information, how long it goes for, how deep we go to, and the price. So it's a great summary. Do you have any more questions? Yep, let's find out what other activities we can do in the Gili Islands while we're there doing scuba diving. Great, we have some suggestions here of other activities we can do. Do you have any more questions? No. And the conversation is ended. And you can see this box popped up here where we could go to another workflow. But that's outside the extents of this Botpress chatbot tutorial. Lastly, you can see up the top, we have the publish button. And if you have permissions to access the website, you'll be able to incorporate this chatbot into that website.
But why should you learn how to build a chatbot? Well, in today's digital era, users demand quick, personalized responses. Chatbots, vital for modern websites, offer 24/7 support, enhance user experience, aid in sales, and provide insights into customer behavior. Their presence is essential for staying competitive in the online landscape. Now check out this video to see how to enable the new ChatGPT voice conversation on iPhone. Also, subscribe to the channel so you can get more AI updates as they happen. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.